Okay, folks, well, welcome back to something a little bit different. Yes, as you've probably gathered, this is Minecraft. You blame my girlfriend for this. It's her fault. She got me into it. And I've really kind of gone at it full bore, I have to be honest, as I do with pretty much everything, as you'll see as we go through. So basically, what I'm going to do today is just give you a little tour of what I have created so far as a bit of a prelude to hopefully some more Minecraft videos, a survival mode playthrough, and some tutorial stuff that we're going to be doing fairly soon. As it stands at the moment, I have to make a few apologies before we start. The audio quality is not going to be very good because I'm using the rubbish microphone that comes with the PS4, which unfortunately is not very good, so I'm hoping you can hear me okay. And also, I'm recording on the PS4 own recording because I don't have an external recorder. So unfortunately, every 15 minutes I am going to have to stop and restart the recording, which is very annoying. But anyway, hopefully we can work around that. And for all the other bits and pieces, I will try my best to get an external recorder. Money's just a bit tight at the minute. But right now, we are going to go on a little bit of a tour of what I've done. And I've started at the furthest point that I've explored. So this is not my spawn point. I've kind of branched out in two different directions from where my spawn point was, and I've done a fair bit of exploring, and I'm up on a watchtower what I have built. It's not quite finished, as you can see. I haven't got the fencing the whole way around it yet, but you can look out over the side, you can look out over your kingdom. But we actually want to go and explore it close up. You can see there's a witch's house over there. So let's make our way downstairs. And you can see that we're on top of a mountain, and you can sort of see the tower. You'll see it better once we get down to the bottom. Pathway to follow around the edge here. It's all heavily lit so that we don't have issues with monsters and things spawning up here. And if we come down here, we have a spiral staircase. This spiral staircase goes all the way down through the mountain to the bottom. It's quite big. It took me forever to build it. It's made mainly out of sandstone slabs with this stone core up the middle. In fact, I think it's made exclusively out of sandstone slabs. I don't think there's any stairs or anything else anywhere in it. And it goes all the way down, all the way down. Obviously heavily lit, so we don't get monsters spawning in here. And eventually we get to the bottom and we come into a tunnel. Obviously the tunnel that way just comes to a bit of a dead end. I'm not going to bother going down there. Craft table here because I'm still working on this bit. This is as far as I've got so far, but I will be going further. And obviously this is just a foot tunnel, but you will see what is planned for this in a moment. So if we keep walking this way, we'll walk out through this tunnel. So we're still inside the mountain. And we're going to walk down and we're going to come out of the other end of the tunnel into the savannah. As you can see, pop out of the tunnel and we are here in the kind of desert environment. You can see there we've got the tunnel mouth, and the tunnel mouth is designed to stop monsters falling into the tunnel. So there's a 2-block high wall above it that they can't get over, and if they fall down the side, they're just going to fall into a big deep hole, which is then also 2 blocks below the level of the path there, so that you can't get up and can't get here. So this will protect the walkway. Obviously, eventually this will also be fenced, so you can't just walk straight onto it. At the moment, this is all a bit unfinished. So if we head round this way, obviously we've got some lots and lots of hardened clay and things in there. I've been mining all of that. This cobblestone. Well, I might as well tell you what it actually is. This cobblestone track bed. Yes, this is for a minecart railway. It's not actually a footpath, it's for a minecart railway. I haven't finished this end of it yet. It will be fenced all the way along to protect it, lit, as you'll see when we get past this little dirt wall, which is house over there. I've already been in and looted it and wiped out the witch. Okay, so I'm just going to jump up into this, and here is the end of the minecart railway. So this is as far as I've currently got it. So I've just put this in just to stop, again, monsters being able to get onto the track. I'm just going to block up that hole that I climbed in through, so again, they can't get into this track. And from this point forward, the whole of the minecart railway system is protected by fences, walls, ditches, and torches, so it's all nice and protected, so monsters can't get onto it, so it's safe. We are in survival mode. That is something that I have not mentioned. Everything that we've done that you're going to see in this video has been done in survival mode. None of it has been done in creative mode. I know, people have queried that, people who've seen this have accused me of doing it in creative mode. I can assure you, it's all in survival mode. So, here we go. Let's get ourselves on the way. Manual kickoff, and then it's powered rails to keep us going. We're going to head into another tunnel, and we're going to pop out the other end at our first waypoint. Our first station on our massive minecart railway that I've built is Ravine. So this is Ravine Station. It was 18th of September that I finished this station off, and this leads into the ravine. This ravine was the first ravine I found in the game that I came and properly explored. There is also another reason why I've kind of landmarked this one. Lots of other ravines I've been in since, but this is the only one that I have found an abandoned mine shaft in. It's just here. I've hacked down a lot of the wood that was in here. You can see the wooden props and things that were here have all gone. I've hacked all that down, but this is an abandoned mine shaft. I've pinched all the wood. You can see bits that I haven't taken it out there. And we've got this little bit of dungeon here with the mossy cobblestone and everything that I haven't really done much with. I've taken all the rails out. There were some chests and things in here that I've also taken out. And when I was exploring this, I built my little sort of base of operations here into a hole in the wall. In fact, I might as well just check these while I'm here, see if there's anything useful that I haven't taken. Nope, took it all. And obviously there is a bed in here. It is actually starting to go a little bit dark out here already. It doesn't take very long, but we should be okay to head to our next waypoint. So this is the ravine. This is the first area. You can see we've got some lava down there as well. And basically we've just explored this ravine, harvested all of its resources. So this is our first sort of major landmark. So let's make our way up back to the station. Okay, so we're back at the top, and it did actually go dark while I was climbing up there, so I just ran back down, slept in the bed, and we are back at the top again. So back to the station, so let's head back through. This is, whoops, did not mean to do that. There we are, stop that from happening again. This is just to stop animals from getting onto the railway line. Originally, I kind of assumed that they wouldn't be able to get in, but they found ways, so I've just put this here, stops the animals getting in, stops the mobs getting in. Mountain extension was started on the 19th of September. I like to do this, just put signs up and record what's happening so we can kind of look back at it later and see what we did and when we did it. You can see here we've got fences the whole way round. We've got walls and fences up above us to protect this station, to stop mobs from being able to get on here. So in theory, we're all nice and safe from monsters and things. They can't get to us. So let's jump in the minecart and we'll carry on. So we're now heading on one of the slightly longer minecart routes through another tunnel out by a lagoon, and I'm actually going to jump out of the minecart here because unfortunately you can't stop it any other way once it gets going. So we've got a bit of a lagoon here, and this is one of our big bridges that I have built. Let's just kick the minecart along a little bit so we can move. Lava fall over there and this grand bridge. Unfortunately I can't really easily get off the bridge. It is actually called Lagoon Bridge, and it was finished on the 18th of September. It's cobblestone, it's fence, and there are actually, I've done this properly, it's not a, you know, floaty bridge of magic. It is actually got pillars and things underneath it to make it look like it's a proper bridge. I will show you when we get to one of the other bridges how I've been building them, one of the ones I can more easily get in and out of. That's obviously the protection that stops monsters getting in, also stops me getting out very easily. So okay, so let's jump back in the minecart. Obviously there we are, another tunnel entrance built the same way so monsters can't fall onto the track, through a little bit of woodland, through an underground cavern that I found, and into an underground station called Mansion Place. So if I jump out of here, that's when we started the ravine extension. So this is where the railway originally ended before I extended it. We come up here, we're in my mansion house, which is unfinished because I kind of got carried away building the railway, but I have a sitting room. I just need to furnish it and decorate it. Come up here, we've got glowstone lamps everywhere. We have a bathroom with a bath in it. Look at this. We need to put some more torches up in here, actually. Bathroom with a bath in it. That's quite cool, isn't it? Need to do a bit more work in there as well. Bedroom, single bedroom. That's the chimney thing from downstairs. Just stone blocks, really, for effect. You see that I'm in the middle of building the ceiling on this. We have another bedroom over here, much bigger. Yeah, and there's also a roof. And I potentially think there's going to be a loft. Come outside. The whole of this is fenced the whole way round. Again, keep the monsters out. I've got dirt, scaffolding, and a donkey. just on the roof there. You can see the way I've built this with brick, stone columns, wood, and there's more wood on the roof. And obviously I've left, these are actually natural sort of ponds that formed with the game spawn, and I've just kind of left them and incorporated them into the garden. I did actually have a zombie wandering around in here at one point, my pet zombie, but I don't know where he's gone. He must have got out of the water and caught fire. That's a bad thing. Okay, so this is my big mansion house. This is my main, you can see I haven't finished the roof. This is my main base of operations, and I will get around to finishing that roof. I've just got a bit carried away with my expansion plans. But there is a little bit of a hidden gem to this place. Oh, by the way, this is the kitchen, which I haven't finished yet, so you can see. Down here, in this here hole, if we head down into the basement, look at this, PS de Resistance, my storage area. There's nothing in that one, but I've got my storage stuff. It's all organized. I've got tree saplings up here, flowers and seeds down here, tools, I've got food, you know, all the just random rubbish, and I've got, you know, weaponry and fuel, metals, and glowstone. I've got a load of leather rack, and, you know, basically it's all organized, it's all sorted out, so we know where everything is. There's nothing in that one yet. So yeah, we can store things, we can come here, we can find exactly what we want for the project that we need, and it's all being brought back here and stored here. I've got just a couple of little buffer things for random stuff. Okay, so that's the mansion house. So let's head back down to the station and we'll head on to the next bit. Whoops, off we go. Right, so back outside, back across the embankment and through some more fenced areas to my next station, which is called Tower Hall. 15th of September. I built the railway out the other direction to the way we're travelling it from this point. So this was open first and then I extended it to the mansion house. There's the first of the lookout towers that I built, so that's a different tower to the one you've already seen. I'm not going to go over there because it'll just take forever, but that's up the hill and acts as a nice little beacon for when you're out exploring. That's why I built them. And obviously there's a path that I've built that leads up to it. I have been putting these buttons to power the rail that stopped us. There's a powered rail with no power to it there, which is what stops the cart. But it doesn't really work very well, so I'm going to change all of that. So let's get ourselves on the way again. Back into another tunnel. And here we have a junction, and we're just going to stop here briefly. This is actually where the railway first was built. And I then built that as an extension. The original start of the railway was actually down this way, which is now a little bit of a spur off the main line. So we've hit a terminus here, which is the home farm terminus. This is where the railway first started, just here. It headed that way and it headed straight along. And now we've got the curved branch. If we come in here, this is, I'm just going to shut that door. This is the home farm. And the home farm is my spawn point. This is where I spawned. And this was my very first building area. So I've got quite a lot here. Obviously this is the farmhouse which I built into the side of a hill. Word of advice, don't do that, it's a pain in the neck. You have to really do a lot of work to stop monsters from falling down from above, so don't do that, it's just a waste of time. But I've got my fully enclosed farmyard here. I've got a fence, a wall with a fence on the top. That walkway heads off to the very first mine that I built, which is just over there. I'll show you that in a minute. Coming this way, I've got my pen full of sheep. I've been breeding sheep in here, and I've also been breeding cows. I've got some cows. I don't know why I put that there. Don't really need it. Over here, I'm growing sugar cane, which is doing quite well. And I've obviously grown wheat, which was my initial food source, and believe me, this is a tiny, tiny little wheat patch compared to what I'm going to show you a bit later. I've also got a tame horse. I found some horse armor in that dungeon that we've already been in the abandoned mine, so he's wearing it, although I don't have a saddle, so I can't ride it. And in here is where I've been growing trees. These are my initial wood supply. So this is my basic wood production facility, which I haven't actually used for a while. I've just left these trees in here. But basically, you just cut them down and then replant more trees. So that's where we were producing wood. So farming trees, basically. So there we go. Watchtower in the background, farmhouse in the front. Heading out through this gate, you can go outside. That's where I first started to explore. We've got the river down there, and we have a jetty. And then you can head off down the river or head off that way. I have got full maps of all this area. So the only problem is I can't remember where they are. They're in a chest somewhere, and I can't remember where I put them. But never mind. Okay, so that's home farm. So what we're now going to do, it's starting to go a little bit dark again, obviously with the day-night cycle, so I think I'm just going to pause here. I'll just sleep in the bed until it gets light again, and then we'll carry on our grand tour. Okay, so it's light again, so we are going to make our way back to the next bit of our tour. But before I do that, I'm just going to eat some food, because my hunger bar is going down a bit there. Get lots of bread. Okay, so let's carry on. I've also harvested the sugar cane, by the way. While we're waiting. Just realised something I forgot to show you through this magical hidden door. Through this magical hidden door, down into the depths. I have a nether portal, and we can go through to the nether. I'm not going to do that right now, but I have built myself a little sort of entry thing on the other side of the nether, as it makes funny noises at me. And obviously we can go into the nether through the hidden nether portal in the basement of home farm. So let's make our way back to the railway, shutting the doors as we go, stop anything that does get in. Okay, so let's jump back on the railway and head back to that junction. Okay, so home farm is my spawn point, so we're now heading off in the other direction that I started exploring. And this is where things start to get a bit grand. Obviously you can notice with my minecart railway, it's powered the whole way down. I'm just going to jump off here. I haven't actually put, this is my farm mine halt, but I haven't actually put a stopping thing here. So if I head down this way, across this little bridge, originally the minecart railway did actually run down here, and this was a terminus, and you can see here, I only kept it open for a week, and then I closed it. But this is my original mine, going deep down. Underground, I've got a little sort of base of operations down here with a few bits and pieces in it, and then you just keep going down and down and down. And then there's another section here that led to a cave that had some monsters in it, so I put a door on it just stopped getting in here. And I've got netherrack, burning netherrack in the walls there, lighting it. And there's some obsidian down here. I don't have a diamond pickaxe at the moment because I lost it, so I can't harvest it, but it's there. And there's sort of, I've done there's some large bits of lava areas down here and all sorts of things. So this is my very first mine. I don't tend to come in here that often now, as I'm tending to go into caves and ravines, but it is still here and I can still use it. So let's head back out. And then that's the walkway that heads to the farm. That's where that walkway goes. So, back over onto the T-shaped bridge. And again, this is all fenced and lit, so it's mob protected. Let's come this way, and let's jump back into the minecart and head back on our way again. Obviously, the minecart railway is powered. Grand bridge. As we pass through the ones, I'll put some towers and things on it. Let me just jump out, because I want to show you the grand bridge. There you are. What about that, eh? That's a proper bridge, that. Look at that. I'm proud of that. It took me ages to do it, but look at that. That's a proper bridge. Impressed? And there's the watchtower. You can see it there in the background. So that's quite a nice image, that. I like that. There we go. So, obviously to get back up, I now need to lay down a block so I can jump up. And then I need to dig it away so nobody else can use it. Jump back in the minecart. And away we go. So the minecart is powered the whole way. Every 40 blocks there's a powered rail with a redstone torch underneath it, which powers us along. And we're going to find our next waypoint, which is a village. This is the very first village that I found. I've only found two. This is the very first one. It's tiny. There's only two people here, and it's very, very small. But I have decided to build the railway here to Riverside Village, which I reached on the 4th of October, and I did not mean to do that. Let's come through the gate. Shut the gate, keep the railway protected from monsters. Build a little pathway just to follow into the village. There's only two villages here. I'm thinking one's an armorer. Yeah, and the other one is a librarian. I have done some trading with the librarian, so his trades are obviously slightly better. Not very much else here. There's just some wheat crops, which I haven't bothered ransacking because I've got plenty of wheat elsewhere. If there were carrots or things, I would probably have those. But anyway, and as well, which is utterly pointless. And that's about it, really. So not much here, but I've rel connected it anyway. Then I did a little bit of exploring, and I found a massive, great big area of water just over there. And obviously some land and some interesting things on the other side. But I didn't fancy building a ridiculously long bridge. So I built a ridiculously long tunnel instead. So let's jump back into the minecart and drop down through my tunnel. Down, down. I had to go 40 blocks down to go underneath the water. And you can see we're going under the water through this very long tunnel. I'm trying to be a little bit economical with my powered rails, because obviously you need gold for powered rails, and I'm not finding very much of it, so I've spaced the powered rails a little bit further apart in this tunnel, which means we really are slowing down before we hit them. And unfortunately, I have actually run out of powered rails, so we're now on to manual as we come back to our next... I won't look that way just for a second. Down in the tunnel, you'll notice when we came back up, there was that little step where it went flat. I came up probably about 10 blocks too early and punched through into the water, so I had to go back down a little bit and go forward a bit. Not too bad though, really, given that it was all just done by eye and just by guesswork as to where to come back up. We came back up pretty much on the shoreline, and if I look this way, I built a lighthouse. So let's jump out. This is Lighthouse Point, 31st of October. This station was opened, although it was actually built a lot earlier than that. It's just the rail reached it on the 31st of October. And it leads down to this little jetty where we could put some boats, and I'm planning on putting some dispensers here with some boats. As it stands at the moment, I haven't actually got a boat, so we're going to have to swim it. Over to my island with my lava lighthouse. And I do need to work on this lighthouse. It's not... the lava at the top isn't quite right. I wanted to try and get a nice square block, but unfortunately I've wound up with a... just a, like a heap of it, which I need to try and sort out. Basically, the top half of the lighthouse is full of lava. Lava lighthouse, 5th of October, and the lava is what obviously provides the light. And there's a little lava beacon here. This was my test piece when I built it to make sure it wasn't going to set anything on fire, and that you were actually going to be able to see it through the glass, which you can. It works very well. And just in here, hidden away, is a little hidey hole. When I first explored over here, this is the big expanse of water that I came across. There's a little bit of land there, but then there's much more water on the other side. The tunnel's running pretty much underneath us, where we are now. When I first came out to explore here, obviously I had to make myself a little forward operations base, and this is what it was. I just dug it in on this little island to protect it, lit the island so the mobs can't spawn on it. Obviously surrounded by water, it's hard for them to swim over to us, so it's nice and safe out here. And I built this little hidey hole as a little forward operations base, and I'm actually still using it whilst I'm extending the railway and doing other things, so there's quite a lot of stuff here at the moment. But yes, this is my little hidey hole. So, shall we carry on with our little grand tour? Okay, so let's head back, swim back across. I think it's starting to go a little bit dark. Will I get to the next bit before it goes dark? I'm a bit worried I won't. I'll tell you what, we'll just have a quick pause. I'll just wait for the sun to come back up. And then we'll head to the next bit, because I don't want to end up doing it in the dark. Because you won't see anything, quite frankly. Okay, well, it's daylight again. I've come back across to the station, Lighthouse Point, and we're going to carry on. Now, the railway doesn't go much further than this, because I'm having a bit of a time finding iron, if I'm completely honest. But let's jump back in, and we'll carry on as far as we can go. So, across a causeway, across the edge of the water here, and into the next tunnel. So there's no powered rails on this bit, so I have to manually kick it along. So, through another tunnel. And then we're going to come out into a little bit of woodland, and we're going to run along the shoreline of more water. And we're going to come to this section, which has a little bit of a bodged mob protection system there, but it works. Okay, and this is where the railway runs out. So this is as far as I have got the actual rails. However, unlike at the other end, I have actually built the complete infrastructure, including all the fences and all the protection for the rest of the way. So it's basically just a footpath from this point on, but it is fully lit, fully fenced and fully protected. So we can carry on, and we are going to carry on as we come out of this tunnel. Ta-da! We have something else. And what is it? It's a farm. This is the big farm. It's not quite finished. This section here, I'm kind of happy with it, but it's just a bit big, so I might just make it a bit smaller. But it's basically, we're going to put some chests here, and that's where I'm going to store the various produce from the farm waiting for collection by rail. If we head through this way, I'm intending to build, obviously there's a pathway just going there at the minute. I want to build a set of steps to get us up here. I'm going to show you this in a minute because this is really quite clever. But if I come up here, I've got a farmhouse which I finished on the 1st of November. Obviously I'm aware there's no glass in that window. But we're going to come in. I have to be honest with you, this isn't my favourite structure. I'm not 100% happy with the way it looks. But we've got a little bedroom there, we've got a carpet, some seating tables, we've got some stuff stored, lots and lots of stuff. There's one of my maps. I don't know where the others are, I honestly can't remember. And we've got wheat and things which are produce of the farm. If we come back out this way, I've got animal pens. However, I'm having some right fun in games keeping the right animals in the right pens. I've wound up with sheep and cows in the same place because they're both attracted to wheat. So when you try and lure the sheep out, you also lure the cow out. But anyway, another pen attached to this one. There's my building. I suppose it's not that bad. The whole farm is fenced all the way around. Well, it's not actually fenced, it's cobblestone wall. But it's protected the whole way around, and it's fully lit again to stop monsters from being able to get in. So this is again a protected area. Also keeps the wolves out so they can't attack my sheep over the wall, over the fences. Dropping down here, I've got a random chicken which doesn't particularly seem to want to move and just keeps giving me eggs, so I'm not too bothered. I am going to try and get it into one of the enclosures. This one here is supposed to be for sheep. This one is meant to be for pigs, the little one is meant to be for chickens, but they are currently all over the place because I don't have the right items to lure them around. Unless I use a lead, I suppose I could do that. But these are the pens. Obviously it's all fully fenced, fully protected. I've got my crop growing beds here, just raised exactly the same as you tend to see in villages, so wooden blocks, or these are actually the oak wood blocks. Strip of water up the middle, which then hydrates four blocks on either side. So I've basically built it out three blocks on either side, and it's farmland. Carrots, beets, potatoes, that's what I'm planning on building here, growing here. I just need to find some. I just don't have any, although I may end up converting one of these to sugar cane. But to do that, I would need to sacrifice two extra rows because I'd need to put more water in to be able to do that. But the pièce de résistance of this whole farm is this. This is the Wheat-O-Matic, as I've called it. Now, I'm going to be honest, I got the original basic idea for this from another YouTube video, another YouTube channel, and I will put a link to it. And we may well do a tutorial at some point showing how to build this, because it is quite cool. But again, I haven't got the idea, the basic idea, from somebody else. I've just expanded it using their principles. So I'm not going to take credit for the design of this, because I have got it from somewhere else. I've just made it bigger. And basically what it does is it allows you to grow, I think it works out to be something in the region about 300 wheat at the same time, and harvest them in bulk. And then it carries the harvested stuff away to one central collection point. Now, the wheat isn't fully grown here, so if I try to harvest it now, I'm mainly going to get seed rather than wheat, and I'm going to have to go and replant it all. But just for you, because I like you all so much, I am going to do it and show you how it works. So basically what happens is, down at the bottom you can see these water channels. The water channels are deliberately set to flow downwards like that. They carry the harvested crops, which I'll show you how it's done in a moment, away. So when we activate the harvesting, everything gets pushed down to the bottom and winds up in this trough, and then it gets washed away underneath. Where that trap door is, that's where the channel goes, and it ends up in that little dugout at the end where we can pick all the produce up. There's three tiers to this. Each tier is 7 blocks wide and 7 blocks long. The reason it's that those dimensions is water hydrates 4 blocks out on either side. Under this wooden section at the end is blocks of water. So they obviously hydrate the soil out 4 blocks. Again, there's water under here as well, which hydrates out 4 blocks. So if I make this 7 blocks wide, it's definitely going to be hydrated all the way across, which allows us to keep it as farmland, helps the crops grow faster. Obviously, the downside, I mean, I could potentially make it 8 blocks wide and it would still work, but I just didn't. I only made it 7. And the reason it's 7 blocks long is more critical, and you'll see why in a minute, but each of these tiers has to be 7 blocks, and then obviously 1 block up, 7 more blocks, 1 block up, 7 more blocks. And the reason for that will come apparent in a minute when I hit the harvest button. So if I come outside, keep that gate shut, stop things wandering in. Obviously, I've got to keep these here because there's water underneath these blocks and I don't want it flowing away. You'll see at the top here, we've got some pistons. These pistons are actually extended at the moment. So they're in their extended position. If I could, oops, I fell off. If I jump back up, on top of the pistons, the back of the mechanism, is water. So pistons are extended, you can see that. And there's a water block on top of each one of them. That's important, you can't just put one on the end, you have to have one on top of each one of these. So there's a water source block on top of each one of those extended piston arms. You can see the redstone and repeaters in here, it's all powered up. If I flick this lever, the pistons retract and the water flows down. And as it flows down, it washes everything away. And that's how you do bulk harvesting. And obviously with this being wheat, when you harvest it, you also get seed back. So you end up with seed and wheat. On this occasion, we're not going to get much wheat because most of it hadn't grown. But when it's fully grown, you get about 300 wheat and about the same number of seed. So it's quite good, actually. So obviously, you can see the water is flowing down. The reason why the 7-block length is important is that water in Minecraft flows 8 blocks. So if you had an 8th block, the water would just stop. Whereas if you have 7 blocks, it will then flow down, and then it will flow another 7 blocks, another 8 blocks. And then it will flow down and flow another 8 blocks. So that's why the 7 blocks are important. If you have 8 blocks, the water just stops. It won't flow. So 7 blocks maximum. Power that back up. That cuts off the water supply. And obviously then the soil is ready to be replanted. Which I'm not going to do now because we're here forever. You can see everything going into the chute, into the loading mechanism. So shut the gate. There's a few that always miss and end up landing on this bit in the middle. It's a bit annoying. There's not much I can do about it. I've tried and it doesn't work, and they also end up on the edge. So there we go. So we've picked up all the stragglers. So now we come down here. This is the collection area and it's all here. And if I jump in, you'll see I've now got lots and lots and lots of seed and some wheat. I actually got 59 wheat out of that, so that's not bad given that most of it hadn't grown. So lots and lots of stuff. So that's the Wheat-O-Matic. That's my biggest creation to date, and I'm really, really happy with that. And that's where I'm getting all this wheat and all this bread from. It's a really good way of keeping your food stocks done. The only downside with it is you do have to go manually replant it. There's no way to automatically replant it, unfortunately. You have to manually do it, and it does take a while. But ultimately, you're harvesting so much wheat in one go, it's better off doing it that way. It's a nice way to do it. So it's sort of semi-automatic wheat farming. Okay, so it's going dark again, so I'm just going to take a pause, I'll have a sleep, and we'll join you back again in the daylight. Okay, so you're back with me. So we are back in the daylight. So we're going to head out of the farmhouse, and we're going to head back onto, well, I don't want to say the railway, because it isn't, but you know what I mean, onto the railway track bed, and we're going to go for a walk. So you can actually see here, we've got a bridge. This is a cobblestone, complete cobblestone bridge. I put cobblestone walls rather than fences along the side. I was a bit short of cobblestone at one point. That's why you've not really seen it until now. Into another tunnel. I've done a lot of tunnels. I have literally tried to keep my minecart railway straight and flat. So I've tunneled through things and bridged over stuff rather than going around it for the most part. It starts to get a little bit more complicated as we head this way. So we're popping out here, we're going across a lake, and we've got another massive bridge. Birch fences here rather than oak that you've seen elsewhere, simply because, well, there's lots of birches there, so that's where I got the wood from. So if we head this way, there's a little island just underneath. That's where one of the columns is that holds this bridge. Well, it doesn't hold the bridge up because obviously it doesn't matter, but it looks like it holds the bridge up. If we head this way, we're into another tunnel. I've tried to keep the track bed cobblestone the whole way, but again, I did keep running out of cobblestone, so I've got sections where I haven't done that, which I probably will dig out the dirt and what have you and put cobblestone down just so it looks the same the whole way. Wherever you see a little cobblestone patch, that's usually where I came across a cave or some coal or something that I've dug out and I needed to fill in the holes. As I've gone through digging these tunnels, I have found quite a lot of caves. Obviously, I want to try and keep the railway protected from monsters, so I've blocked off most of those caves. I've explored a few, picked out their resources, then blocked them off. But most of them I've just basically protected. Okay, so coming out the other end of this tunnel, more water, another lake. We're heading into the desert here. Again, two block gaps the whole way around, and we do actually need to put a fence on top of that to protect it. But we're now going to do a little bit more fiddly now. It's not going to be as level. We're not straight, we're not level, because I didn't want to build yet another bridge. So I've gone round the edge instead. So if we head down this way, you can see we're heading over the water on this embankment. I've dug out a two block wide trench the whole way around this to try and protect the line. We're going to head into another tunnel. That tunnel's then going to make a bend, and it's going to make another bend, and it's going to head through the mountain. And there is a reason why it's done that, and that's because on the other side, I needed to start trying to line things up with the next set of, well, the final building, actually, on our grand tour. So if we come out here, obviously I've run out of fence at this stage, so it's not fully fenced. But I needed to line this up properly so that we went into this tunnel in this specific place. So, again, I've run out of cobblestone wall as well, so I need to get some more cobblestone wall to finish this little bridge off. But I've brought it up here so that there's space to pass a boat underneath if you wanted to. And then we've come in. Plus, I also needed to change the height slightly to get through the tunnel. This tunnel is in a very specific place, and the reason for that is because I kind of started from the other end and worked backwards and had to make the two halves meet. So we're going to go down a little slope here, go around another bend, and now we're intersecting where I came in from the other direction. And we're heading into the desert, and again, this hasn't been fully fenced and protected yet. And we are heading towards, you could probably just glance it in the right hand corner, but I didn't want to kind of, it's all a little bit jiggly, this bit. It goes around lots and lots of corners, so into another little tunnel. Tunnels were easier. Tunnels are an easier way to protect the line. We're going to pop out. We've got a fenced section and a section where I've run out of cobblestone wall again that I need to sort it out. And then we're coming onto an embankment. So this bit's a bit wiggly. It's not very straight, this, because I've been trying to work around the various hills and landscape. So this is all protected with the big trenches on either side. A little bridge across the internal cavern there. And then we're popping out into this final little section. We've got a snowy biome off that way. Water, massive amounts of water off that way. You can see where it ends. We're actually at the end of the line, or the end of the track bed as it is. Goes in a little U-shape because we're on a station here. And then it goes off that way because there's actually another village over there. I'm not going to bother going across because I haven't got a boat and it's a long way, but I'm going to be building a bridge over. Simply because that tunnel that I built was such a nightmare, I don't want to do another one. Climbing up this here set of cobblestone stairs, we get to the Snow Lodge, which is a little lodge built up on the top of the snow biome. I've got some more wheat growing here. This wooden section here is to stop the water from freezing, so it protects the water and stops it from freezing. Underneath there keeps that soil hydrated, keeps the wheat crop growing. I did build this as a little garden, but I've kind of come up with a different way of doing that. I think it's going to be a bit better, so I'm going to go off and do this. This is a little sheep pen. The only slight downside is I need to do some work on the other side because wolves leant over the wall and killed my sheep. So I need to work on the other side. That's a piece of snow. It snows up here, and the snow then settles on everything. So I planted this tree in the little garden. You can see it's got some snow on it. And inside the snow lodge is Sammy, my dog. He tends to stay here because I've lost several dogs. So Sammy just stays here, don't you, fella? Yes, you're quite happy ignoring me there, aren't you, matey? Yes, thank you. So, this is only a small little lodge. I've got a bed. I've got some stuff. Lots and lots of snow, as you can probably imagine, gathered over here. I've got my little decking, which is built out on some little columns under there. Massive amount of water. Obviously, when we expand the railway, it's going to head off that way, and there'll be a village over there. But this is as far as I've come so far. So we've got a little snow lodge. I've actually got another set of chests up there. Oh, and that's where my maps are. Excellent. And I've got some diamond. I forgot I had that. So I've got another diamond pickaxe. And that is... I think I just knocked one of mine. Did I just punch you, Sammy? I'm terribly sorry about that. I didn't mean to do that. Oh, and I knocked one of my torches off the wall as well, didn't I? I'm going to put that torch... I'm terribly sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Hope you're not mad with me. You're not mad with me, you know, because he's too friendly for that. Okay, so there we are. So this is as far as we have got. So this is the complete Minecraft world that I have built. So what we're going to do is aim to do some tutorial stuff. I'm trying to draw up a list of things that I might try and do. So if you want to see anything specific, stick it in the comments and we'll see what we can do. The minecart railway is a pretty big thing for me, obviously being a railway enthusiast as well. It's not surprising that I've built a minecart railway, and I will show you how I've gone about doing all of that and the best ways to go about doing it. I'm also going to show you some exploring and the best ways to go exploring, certainly for me. And I think we're going to do that all in another survival sandbox. So we'll start with another survival game from scratch, and we'll kind of do a survival let's play whilst we kind of do some of this stuff, and we'll do some dedicated tutorials as well. And I might even do some of it in creative mode, some of these tutorials, so we can do some really grand stuff without having to go and faff around finding all of the bits. Although that said, I do tend to prefer survival mode. So what I think we're going to do is I'm going to do an end-to-end run on the railway. Obviously, that does mean quite a long walk back for me to get back to the end of the current rails. But I'm just I think we're going to do that because I'm just interested to see myself, really, how long it takes to get from one end to the other. So if you bear with me, I'll make my way back down and I shall see you there for a final run through the railway. Okay, well that took a while, but we are back, and we are in the daylight, and we are in the minecart, so let's have a run and see how long it takes us. So, back we go, through the woodland, past the edge of the lake. This bit's all manual, back into the tunnel, through the mountain. Across the causeway, past the lighthouse. I'm not going to stop anywhere on this, I'm going to keep it rolling. Into the tunnel. Through the long, long undersea tunnel. It's a long way to the other end. Powered the whole way from this point, although I think I might need just to rethink the distances of the powered rails in this tunnel a little bit. So coming back up the other side, back past the riverside village, carrying back around again, round the edge of the lake on the big embankment, across the edge of the water, crossing the big lagoon there, over the estuary, and then over the big river on the Grand Bridge. Across another embankment, back to the original area, so the first mine into the tunnel, to the home farm junction, and the original spawn point. We're going to carry on though, and we're going to head back past Tower Holt, through the woodland, to the mansion house. Carry on, back out into the forests again, back into the woods, through the next tunnel, through the underground cavern, more forest out onto the lagoon and across the lagoon bridge. This was the first bridge I built, by the way. Back into the tunnels. And then onto the dogleg and to the ravine. And then carry on across the pond, into the tunnel, through the mountain, across the causeway, and to the current terminus. And I'm now going to inadvertently go back the other way. I didn't mean to do that. And here we are, Witch's House over there. The other watchtower is over here. We have completed our journey all the way around, all the way from one end to the other. So that's basically what I've created. So what we're going to do, we're hopefully going to do some tutorials. We're hopefully going to do a survival mode playthrough. I'm hopefully going to get an external recording box so that we don't have to do this ridiculous 15-minute rigmarole. And also I can get a proper microphone hooked up to it, because this is also not brilliant. But for now, I am going to say thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you again very, very soon.